हेलो गाइस, वेलकम एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल जेवियर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल।
सो हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज स्टैटिस्टिक्स। ओके, चैप्टर नंबर 20। सो हियर इन द फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द मीन एंड मीडियन of our ungrouped data. Okay, so here the formula for the mean, it's very easy. I hope you know that the formula. So suppose you have a ungrouped data, suppose x1, x2, x3, x4 up to n, xn. Okay, that means n terms are will be there. So if you want to find out the mean of that ungrouped data, so here the formula to find out the mean, that is x1 plus x2 plus x3 dot 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 up to suppose xn, then divided by the total numbers, that means n. Or you can also write down, in short, summation xi divided by n. Okay, here I means 1 to n. Clear? Now if you want to find out the median, okay, so to find out the median, in that case here you have two conditions. Because suppose you have odd number of terms and you have also the even number of terms. Either you have odd number of terms or you have even number of terms. So for the median, when you have odd number of terms, that means when n is odd, so in that case the formula will be, for the median it will be n plus 1 by 2th term. Okay, n plus 1 by 2th term. And for the even, here the formula will be n by 2th term. Clear? I repeat, n by 2th term plus n by 2 plus 1th term. Then the summation will be divided by 2. So these are the formula for the median. Now let's move on to the exercise problem. Then we'll discuss about this formula very easily. Okay, so here the first problem. Some number, it's exercise 20.1. And guys, if you like my video, please share this video and please subscribe my channel. So here the first one, find the mean of 8, 6, 10, 12, 1, 3, 4 and 4. Okay, so you have these numbers. How many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 8 numbers are there. So if you want to find out the mean, so mean will be the addition of the 8 numbers. So write down the numbers and then divide it by 8. As here, total 8 numbers. So it will be a 48 by 8, that one equal to 6. It's very easy. Okay. Next, number 2. 5 people were asked about the time in a week they spent in doing social work in their community. They replied 10, 7, 13, 20 and 15 hours respectively. Find the mean time in a week devoted by them for social work. Very easy. Again, just write down 10 plus 7 plus 13 plus 20 plus 15 divided by 5. Okay. So that one equal to here 65 by 5, that one equal to 13. So 13 hours is the mean. Next, number 3. The enrollment of a school during 6 consecutive years was as follows: 1620, 2060, 2540, 3250, 3500 and 3710. Okay, so here the mean will be, first you have to add this number 1620 plus 2060, 2540, 3250, 3500 and 3710. Then divided by how many numbers? 6. So here 16680 divided by 6, that one equal to 2780. Okay, now the fourth one. find the mean of the first 12 natural number. So first here you have to write down the natural number. You know the natural number start from 1. So in that case, your mean will be 1 plus 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and the last one here 12, because first 12 natural number, then divided by 12, because total numbers here 12. So 78 divided by 12, it's 6.5 as your answer. Next, some number 51. Find the mean of first 6 prime numbers. Okay, I hope you know that which are prime numbers. Prime numbers means the number which are divided by 1 and itself. Okay, the number which is divided by 1 and itself. So here the first prime number is 2, second one 3, then 5, 7, 11 and 13. These are the first 6 prime numbers. So mean equal to here 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 11 plus 13, then divided by here 6. As 6 prime numbers are there, so 41 by 6, that one equal to 6.8333. It's just approximate. Okay, so that will be your answer. Now next, for number 2, find the mean of first 7 odd prime numbers. Okay, remember that first 7 odd prime numbers. So in that case, here the first number will be 3, because 2 is an even number. So first number 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, after that 17 and then 19. So these are the first 7 prime numbers odd. Okay, so 75 by 7, and that one equal to 10 whole 5 by 7. Now next, some number 6. Here some number 6, 1. The mark out of 100 obtained by the group of students in a mathematics test that are 81, 72, 90, again 90, 85, 86, 70, 93, and 71. Find the mean marks obtained by the group of students. So first here, find out how many students are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Total 9 students are there. So here mean mark equal to, write down the addition of these 9 numbers. So 90, 90, then here 85, 86, 70, 93, 71, and then divided it by 9. So first find out the summation, that is 738 divided by 9, it's 82. Okay, 82 is your answer. Number 2, the mean of the age of 3 students, Vijay, Rahul, Rakhi, is 15 years. Okay, so here mean equal to 15 years of 3 students. If their age are in the ratio 4:5:6. So definitely if x will be the constant, so the age will be 4x, 5x and 6x. Now you know the formula for mean. So according to the problem, you can write down 4x plus 5x plus 6x divided by 3. That one equal to here 15. So here 10, 15x equal to 15 into 3. 15, 15 cancel out, x equal to 3. Okay, so here the age of Vijay. For Vijay, it's 4 into 3, 12 years. Now next, for Rahul. Okay, for Rahul, that one equal to here 5 into 3, it's 15 years. And for Rakhi, here 6 into 3, 18 years. Okay, now next one, some number 7. The mean of 5 numbers is 20. Okay, mean of 5 numbers. If one number is excluded, mean of remaining numbers become 23. Find the excluded number. Okay, so as here mean of 5 numbers is 20, so let the excluded number is x. Okay, let The excluded number is x. So here mean of five numbers, that one equal to here 20, then total of five numbers, 20 into 5, that one equal to 100. Okay, now mean of four numbers, that one equal to here 23, then total of four numbers here 23 into 4, so 3 fourths are 12, it's 92. Okay, so therefore the excluded number, you have to just subtract 92 from 100, and that is 8. So if you let it x, so definitely the value of x equal to 8. Okay, now next sum number 8. The mean of 25 observation is 27. Okay, mean of 25 observation, that one equal to here 27. So definitely total equal to here 27 into 25. If one observation is included, the mean still remains 27. Find the included observation. So let the number be x. So if you add x with that one, here 27. So first find out the total number here. Okay, so 27 into 25, that one equal to 675. So if you add x with that 25 observation, that means now you have total 26 numbers, okay, or 26 observation. And here the total of 26 observation, total of 26 observation, that one equal to 675 plus 26. Okay, sorry, 675 plus x, not 26. Sorry for that one, x. Okay, and now as here you have, according to your problem, here the mean still remains 27. So that means 675 plus x divided by 26, that one equal to 27. So 675 plus x, that one equal to 27 into 26, it's 702. So here x equal to 702 minus 675, that is 27. So 27 is your answer. Now next one, sum number 9. The mean of 5 observation is 15. If the mean of the first 3 observation is 14 and that of the last 3 is 17, find the third observation. So here mean of 5 observation, okay, that one equal to here 15. Now mean of first 3 observation, mean of first 3 observation, that one equal to here what, 14. Okay, so that means here total of first 3 observation, 14 into 3. Okay, 14 into 3, so multiply it, it's 42. Okay, now here total, here also find out total of 5 observation, that one equal to 15 into 5, and it's 75. Okay, 15 into 5, it's 75. Now here that of the last 3 is 17, the mean of the last 3, okay, the mean of the last 3, that one equal to here 17. So write down here mean of last 3 observation, that one equal to 17. So total of last 3 observation, that one equal to 17 into 3, and it's 51. Okay, so that means if the five numbers a plus c plus d plus e, that one equal to here 75. Now next one here, total first 3, that means here a plus b plus c, that one equal to here 42. Okay, and the last three, that means C plus D plus E equal to 51. So as here A plus B plus C equal to 42, so definitely here in the place of A plus B plus C, you can write down here 42 plus D plus E, that one equal to 75. So here D plus E equal to 75 minus 42, okay, and that one equal to 33. And here C plus D plus E equal to 51. So if D plus E equal to 33, then C equal to 51 minus 33, and that one equal to 18. Okay, so here C equal to 18. That is your answer. Now sum number 10, the last one. So guys, if you like my video, please share this video and please subscribe my channel. So here the mean of 8 variates is 10.5. so mean equal to here 10.5, then total equal to here 10.5 into 8. okay, total equal to here 10.5 into 8, that one equal to here 84. If 7 of them are 3 15 7 19 2 17 8, then find the 8 variate. So here the 8 variate equal to, first just add the 7 numbers and then subtract it from the total. So here 3 plus 15 plus 7 plus 19 plus 2 plus 17 plus 8. So 84 minus, just add it, 3 plus 15 plus 7 plus 19 plus 2 plus 17 plus 8. It's 71. Okay, so 71, that one equal to here 13. So 13 is your answer.